Welcome to Harvesting Clouds, where we take a practical approach to learning and leveraging clouds. In this video, we will be learning how to set up Azure Automation accounts. Let's jump right into it. As you can see, I'm already logged into Azure portal. To create automation account, just like creating any resource in Azure, I'll click on the plus new icon on the top left side. I'll be presented with different categories. From these categories, I'm interested in monitoring and management category. In this category, you will click on the automation, which is the third option from the top. You will be presented with Add Automation Account wizard, wherein you will provide all the inputs required to create automation account. The first input that you require is a name. For this demo, I'll provide the input as demo automation account. You can select a subscription. If you have multiple subscriptions, you will be presented with a dropdown from where you can select one of the subscription that you want. Third option that you need to provide is the resource group. You can use one of the existing group or you can create a new one. I'll provide the name as Archie-Demo Automation. You can provide any name, just make sure that the name is descriptive enough so that later on you can determine what this resource group contains. Also, try to logically contain all your resources into one resource group, which share the same lifecycle. Next, I will select one of the location where I want to deploy this automation account. You will always want to deploy the automation account near to all the resources which you want the automation to work against. Last option is to create an Azure Run As account. This account is created out of the box for you, which is based on a service principle. Using this Azure Run As account, you can take actions on various different resources. For example, you can shut down a VM, you can start a VM in an automated fashion from Azure Automation Runbook, leveraging this Azure Automation Run As account. Once I'm ready, I'll click on the Create button, which will perform the validation whether this automation account can be created or not, and then we'll submit the deployment. I can check the progress of the deployment by clicking on the deployment task in the notifications bar. I can also click on the bell icon at the top right to see how the deployment is progressing. As soon as the deployment is completed, I'm provided with the option to navigate to the resources, wherein I can navigate to my automation account. You can see that the Run As account is created immediately after the automation account is created. Now, I'll click on Go to Resource to navigate to my Azure Automation account. To dismiss the notifications, I'll click on the bell icon at the top right. Now, this is one way to navigate to your automation account. Once you start creating multiple automation accounts, you will want to view all your automation accounts and navigate to the one which you require. So I'll close out of this and will show you the other navigation option. From the left-hand side, from all the navigation options, you will go to Automation Accounts and all your automation accounts in the subscription that you have selected will be listed in here. You can filter by different options. You can filter by name, by subscription, by resource group, by location. And if you have any grouping, you want to group the automation accounts by resource group, by type, subscription, etc., you can do that as well. I'll navigate to the automation account that we just created, which brings me to the same blade, same Azure Automation account blade that we saw earlier. That's all for this video. In the next video, we'll be delving deep into some of the concepts related to Azure Automation account, and we'll start using this automation account to do various tasks. Thank you.